Let's see how we can preprocess our data for masked language modeling. As a reminder, masked language modeling is when a model needs to fill the blanks in a sentence. To do this, you just need text, no labels, as this is a self-supervised problem. To apply this on your own data, just make sure you have all your text covered in one column of your dataset. Before we start randomly masking things, we'll need to somehow make all those texts the same length to batch them together. The first way to make all the texts the same length is the one we use in text classification. Let's batch the short texts and truncate the long ones. As we have seen when we preprocess the data for text classification, this is all done by our tokenizer with the right option for padding and truncation. This will, however, make us lose a lot of text if the examples in our dataset are very long, compared to the context length we picked. Here, all the portion in gray is lost. This is why a second way to generate examples of text with the same length is to chunk our text in pieces of context length, instead of discarding everything after the first chunk. There will probably be a remainder of length smaller than the context size, which we can choose to keep and pad or ignore. Here is how we can apply this in practice, by just adding the return overflowing tokens option in our tokenizer call. Note how this gives us a bigger dataset. This second way of chunking is ideal if all your texts are very long, but it won't work as nicely if you have a variety of lengths in text. In this case, the best option is to concatenate all your tokenized texts in one big stream, with a special token to indicate when you pass from one document to the other, and only then split the big stream into chunks. Here is how it can be done with code, with one loop to concatenate all the text and another one to chunk it. Notice how it reduces the number of samples in our dataset here. There must have been quite a few short entries. Once this is done, the masking is the easy part. There is a data collator designed specifically for this in the Transformers library. You can use it directly in the trainer or when converting your dataset to TensorFlow datasets before doing keras.fit with the 2TF dataset method.